Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Survival Let's Play. Sorry about last week, I kind of ran out of time, but I'm happy to be back. First things first, we gotta get some food because I can't even sprint right now. Oh my god. That's like the second time this series. So my plans for this episode is probably to make some kind of build to have a permanent farm within, and then maybe go explore a little more afterward. Let's see. Oh, we got some iron in the furnace. That's nice. Okay, perfect. Let's make a new iron hoe so we can till some more farmland. And then. Yeah, okay. I kind of want to build a castle at some point in this series. I feel like that'd be pretty fun. Okay, let's take out this cow so we can get some food. Any wheat grown? Okay, there is a bit of wheat that's grown. Let's grab that so we can at least make a piece of bread. Okay, encoding is overloaded again, so we're gonna turn settings down. Can't wait till Distant Horizons is up to date. There we go, looks better now. Take that out. Drop the beef in so we can at least get a little bit. Oh, we got some food there. Oh, I just realized my sounds are down. I was at a mob grinder in a server I play on, so that's probably why. Well, this is better. Okay. So, I'd like to build probably like a nice overhang roof farm for crops over there. We'll put like seeds for carrots, melon, pumpkins, like all the types of food over there. And then connected to that, we'll have like a barn and an area for some animals. I think that would be nice. Mangrove would be really nice for this, but I don't have any of that, so we're probably just gonna have like a pure oak. Chop down a few trees then. Not too worried about getting saplings anymore. Obviously, if I pick any up, I'm gonna replant them, but I'm not gonna go out of my way to grab them at this point. Besides, I run through here often, so it's highly likely that I'll just happen to pick some up. Okay. So I think we do it over here. We can have a nice irrigation system tunneling through here to get to the farmland. And then we'll build actually I might want to flatten this a little bit instead of coming over here. So we have a larger area. We don't need a really big farm, but it's gotta be a decent size. Yeah, let's destroy this area. Okay, so I think I'm gonna leave this tree that's right here to be nice scenery behind the barn, so I want to fill this in. Let's destroy this, and we'll fill that little gap. Thank you. the farm will go, or not the farm, the barn will go in this area here. There will be a path up from, we'll bring a river through here to make like a nice plant field. And there will be a path from the edge of that plant field to the front of the barn. We'll have like nice coarse dirt and grassy platforms underneath where the animals will go in their little fence containers, and pillars up to the overarching roof. I should be able to add a ladder to get to a top floor where we'll have like hay bales and stuff. That should be pretty cool. Okay, let's start with the easy part, the little river to farmland. Let's grab our hoe, and we will start, let's actually start on this level of ground. So we have 2, 3, 4. Not make it like perfect. I'm kind of digging that. Let's start a little bit of the barn. I want probably a 3x3 path and an opening and path through. Let's make that a little bit taller. So we'll do here. Because we gotta make it symmetrical. Nice, and so then we will have bam, bam, bam. And then this will be where the next opening is. So these will be where our pillars will go. Alright, let's go to sleep, make a new home, and probably grab some carrots or other foods that are plantable, if we have any. So let's take, oh perfect, we already got some water. Let's expand this a little bit, so we can have a little bit of pumpkin field over this. I think that looks good. We might change it later, though. Okay. I guess I'm gonna go mining for a bit. I might cut it out. I might just time-lapse it. I'm not sure at the moment. Obviously, you guys will know because you'll see it in the video. But either way, I'll see you and talk to you again at the end of that. Woo, I almost just fell down there. Diamonds. Found some. Okay, well, pickaxe is broken. Heading back up to the surface. It's a pretty successful mining trip. I got 5 diamonds. That's about it, but I got some other types of decorative stones that'll be pretty useful. So I'm gonna head up. I'm probably gonna grab some from that barn. I would like to finish it, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to within this episode. Like it's, yep, night and it's raining. Wow, that is kind of depressing. Although it is pretty nice sunset. Okay, I just realized the coating's overloaded, so I'm gonna calm down a little bit. All I'm gonna do is grab some wheat from my farm. And make sure I replant it immediately so I can make the most use of this rain. And honestly, I might stay out for the night, do some lighting up around my base. And let it rain on my crop so I can get some more growth. Little pro tip, I'm not sure if you guys do this, but crops will grow faster in Minecraft if it's raining. So they also do need light to grow, so I'm going to have to place some torches around it. Still got a bit overloaded in the building, which is just a little bit sad, but... Yep, there goes my shovel. A new pickaxe and a new shovel while we're in here. Let's chuck these diamonds into the chest. I'm not going to use them for a diamond pickaxe quite yet. I'm going to save them. Both to make a enchantment table later on. I have enough for both, which is really lucky on my part. But I need an enchantment table and a pickaxe, and once I can do that, I'll level the enchantment table up and get a fortune. And I believe, as long as it's the very first enchant of the game, you're guaranteed a fortune enchantment for your pickaxe. I think I'm probably gonna either search around, see if I can find any crops, and then probably end the video there. So we'll probably give it like 5 or 10 minutes of just exploring. We're gonna head in this direction today. Oh, and there's water almost immediately. In that case, let's kind of curve around the land that we have. get back, we'll just follow the contour of the land. Is that turtles? There's turtles! Ouch. Kind of broke my leg there, but it's fine. Because there's turtles! Hi, turtles. What do I need to breed turtles? Seagrass, kelp? I think it's... seagrass. But I think we need to shake this up. Yeah. Okay, we could try kelp, but... Yeah, I figured. This is a pretty nice looking mountain over here. Actually, wait a second. This is a really nice mountain. With a little bit of terraforming to build this side out, it kind of is like Mumbo's armchair. Oh, and it goes into a cave. This is sick. I'll have to remember this is here. Yeah, I'll definitely have to remember this because this could be really cool. Okay, I don't have any more food on me. So I guess we'll just make another big loop around, and I think that'll probably be the end of the video. Shipwreck. Okay, this is interesting. This is interesting. I'm glad I did this. Oh, encoding overloaded. I guess I'm loading. Sorry about that, everyone. Still, this is exciting. The paper that could be useful for books. Buried treasure map. Some leather boots, gunpowder and gold. Yeah, I guess I can use this for jungle wood if I end up needing it that badly, but I don't want to demolish it just because. Okay, let's see. Is this close? This is kind of close. Is it on this beach right here? I think it might be. It is. What are the chances? Okay, well, I guess I'm digging up this buried treasure, and then I'll go home and end the video. Found it! Emerald, heart of the sea, that's useful. Some iron, some gold, water breathing potion, cooked salmon. And we'll leave the chest there so we can see why it was all dug up. I can't believe I was digging in the wrong direction for such a long time. But anyways, let's get home. That was a great find. I'm glad I went exploring. I'm gonna hold this so we can see if it gets close enough to leave our home visible. I don't think it will. Oh yeah, our home's on that little Jetty Peninsula there. All the way over, though. Not peninsula, because it's not an ocean. It's just... Anyways. We'll leave the sugarcane farm for now, because I do not feel like going through all that. I think I might have accidentally made some persistent chickens over here. Because these guys, even though I've gone pretty far, they don't seem to be despawning. So we'll make some more persistent chickens, and we'll just have some chickens around here, and eventually we can lure them over and put them in the barn. Let's go see if any of the other stuff over here by the barn has grown. Oh, pumpkin grown. Oh yeah. We gotta celebrate this occasion. Oh, how does the recipe go? This is it, right? I guess I gotta check the recipe book. It's been a while since I made pumpkin pie. Oh, conduit is Nautilus shells, right? Yeah, okay. Don't think I have it. Oh, I do have it in my recipe. Oh, you need an egg. Oh, persistent chickens. I see you over there. You better have some eggs for me. No egg, no egg. No egg. Really? Why is there always an egg when I don't want it and never an egg when I need one? Egg. Okay, I don't want to hold it lest I accidentally throw it. Bam, bam, bam. Pumpkin pie. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Tastes good. I really thought there was wheat in pumpkin pie. Anyways, that's going to be the end for today's episode. Thank you, everyone, for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. Oh. I don't want him to be angry at me. Where did he go? He's gone. Okay. Oh, no, he's back. Hello, sir. How's your day been? Oh, he's on top of the tree. Oh, he's back over there. Honestly, I'm under safe spot now. Ender pearl and a grass block. That's useful. I'm gonna hold on to that because I can use that to spread some grass around in places it wouldn't normally be able to get to easily. Anyways, now for real, that's the end of the episode. Thank you all for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. See you all next time, next Wednesday. Bye.